Hey everybody, it's Zach. It's been a while, hasn't it? Today I'm going to do a haul video. This haul video is not only going to consist of books, but it's also going to consist of some clothes that I've picked up recently, some things I've found at the thrift store, some candles, and a little bit of hair product. The first book I picked up was All the Light We Cannot See. This is a historical fiction novel, and I've heard so many great things about it, specifically from Regan over at Peruse Project. She gives really great reviews, and I really respect her opinions. I'm really excited to read this because I've been wanting to immerse myself more into adult literature, and I think this is going to be a great place to start. The next book I acquired was Yes Please by Amy Poehler. I love Amy Poehler. I think Parks and Rec is a perfect television show, and I'm very excited to read this. I've been flipping through it, and I've just run into some very funny little lines, so I'm sure this is going to be a great, great read. I love going thrift shopping. My town has quite a few for its size, but I oftentimes don't run into things that I think are worth picking up. But just a couple weeks ago, I was at Goodwill and I found two great pairs of shoes that were considered a steal in my mind. The first being this brown pair of Cole Haan loafers. I was very excited to find these loafers in my size. I wear a size 11 and these shoes fit wonderfully. They have a very nice weight to them, which I like. The only thing I don't really like is the sole on the right shoe is just a little bit broken, but I'm sure just a little bit of glue will be able to fix that. These shoes definitely have a little bit of wear on them, but given that they were only $10 and that they're Cole Haan's, that's definitely something that I'm able to live with. The next pair of shoes I picked up at the thrift store were these light brown O'Sullivan dress shoes. These are size 10.5, and while my feet do fit, they are not the most comfortable. I was up in the city this weekend and I wore these the entire day, and they were quite uncomfortable after the first hour. I think these are shoes that I'm going to have to limit my wear time in. I think I'm going to just have to limit these to maybe a nice evening. But nonetheless, I do really enjoy them. They have some very nice detail work up the sides, and they are built very well. They have a nice weight to them, a nice heel, and like the Cole Haan's, they do have some wear on them, but given that, again, these are only $10, it's something I'm definitely able to live with. I could not resist Forever 21's Cyber Monday sale. It was either 30 or 40% off, I don't quite remember, but I got a few items. The first thing being this greenish tealish pullover with this loose turtleneck thing going on up here. I love this because it's super casual, it has some awesome detailing on the shoulders, and it has very convenient pockets down on the front. This will pair great with some dark wash jeans, some chinos, or even a pair of khakis. Given that I'm a business student, I have to go business casual to a lot of my classes, and for that reason, I went ahead and picked up two polos. One is in the same tealish green as that pullover, and then the other one is in black. I really like these polos because they have the contrasting collar, as well as a nice amount of buttons on the front. They also have cuffs around the arm that are the same contrasting color as the collar. I can't wait to wear these polos with a nice pair of chinos, khakis, and maybe a nice pair of loafers. While I was scrolling through the Forever 21 site, I ran across this beauty and I had to pick it up. It made me smile. It is a sweater that has robot print all over it on the front and on the back. This is such a fun print and I don't really have that many fun things in my wardrobe, so I'm definitely excited to add this. And then I picked up a Dare sweater. It says, "Dare to resist drugs and violence." I really like the message of this sweater. It's just a more casual sweater, something I could wear with maybe just a pair of sweatpants if I'm lounging around the house, or a pair of jeans if I'm going out. The only thing I dislike about this sweater is it's not the most proportional. The neckline is rather large, and the sleeves aren't as long as I would ideally like. The final thing I picked up at Forever 21 was this scarf. I've only worn this a couple times, and I've gotten quite a few compliments. It gets rather cold here, so I think this scarf will definitely come in handy this winter. I have a weakness when it comes to high-quality shampoo. I spend a lot of time in chlorine pools, so when I shower, I like to shower with high-quality shampoos. So I went to Ulta and I picked up 4 liters of shampoo. The first being Big Sexy Hair Sulfate-Free Volumizing Shampoo. I love this product because when I get out of the shower, I feel like my hair just has so much volume, more volume than I get with any other shampoo or any other product alone. It has a really nice citrusy floral smell, and while though the smell is a little bit feminine, it's not overpowering by any means. And then I picked up a liter of American Crew Power Cleanser Style Remover. I've never used the shampoo before. I don't really like the smell that much. I don't really think it has that great of a smell. It also is a little bit runny. I've yet to really use the product that much to give you a good review of it, but I'll definitely let you know what I think of it once I use it more. And then I picked up 2 liters of Paul Mitchell's Tea Tree Shampoo. I absolutely love this product. It has such a great smell to it. You use it in your hair, and it just has such a great mint smell. It kind of like tingles your scalp a little bit, which feels great. And I cannot say enough great things about the shampoo. If you haven't tried it, go out and pick some up. I love burning candles, but I needed candles that had more of a winter fragrance. So I went to Bath & Body Works and picked up 4 candles. The first being this mini candle. It is Cranberry Woods. And it says fresh tart cranberries, blackcurrant, and warm cinnamon bark combined in a delightful fragrance inspired by the magic of woods during harvest time. It has just a very nice, warm, kind of woodsy cranberry smell, and I very much like this one. The next being this mini lavender vanilla. It says a blend of 2 timeless scents, lavender and creamy vanilla, becomes unforgettable with touches of cedarwood, delicate jasmine with citrus. Then I picked up this mini candle called Leaves. It is a fragrance that embodies the richness of the season with all of its color and pleasures. Features notes of golden nectar, ripe, delicious apples, and red berries. To me, this kind of just smells like a fruit basket blended together, but it's not too overpowering or not too like sugary smelling, if that makes sense. My favorite candle that I picked up a big one. It is Fresh Balsam. And this candle says, this invigorating aroma of evergreen woods on a clear fall morning features crisp fir needles and cedarwood musk notes. And it just smells so fresh and so woodsy in such a great way. I'm so excited to start burning this candle. So those are the things I accumulated during the month of December. It's a lot more than I normally accumulate, but given that the holidays are coming up soon, I kind of took that as an opportunity to not only treat my friends and family, but also treat myself. It's been a hard year, so I was just kind of rewarding myself with a few nice things. Like always, I'm going to go ahead and leave my social media information in the description below. Feel free to add or follow me there on any of that. And until next time, take care. Bye.